In the New York luxury real estate market, the median price on the most expensive co-ops and condos rose 6.4% in the first quarter. You compare that to a negative 11% drop across all price ranges. But that said, even buyers in the $10 million price point space need confidence to buy. I sat down with New York City's top luxury broker, Dolly Lenz, to talk about this point.
The mood and the tone is chipper. It's good, but there is really no absorption. I mean, if you really know the numbers, there's no depth to the market. I know almost every sale going on, which is probably not a good thing, but the sales are going on, so much better than last year.
So much better than last year, but mm-hmm. if you compare it to 3 years ago...
Right, that's where we fall off.
It still hurts.
Yeah, it's. I mean, probably volume is off 40%. I mean, that's tremendous.
So are you seeing any forced sales? I mean, is it that bad in the luxury space?
I am seeing what I might know as a forced sale. The buyer may not know it's a forced sale, but yes, we are seeing forced sales.
Is there any change in the profile of luxury buyers right now? I mean, how many foreigners are coming in? What is the stronger dollar doing to this market?
The stronger dollar is hurting the market, hurting the condominium market, hurting the townhouse market vis-a-vis Europeans. So definitely people
are... Because last year they had a 30% off sale.
Exactly. And now they're saying, well, gee, I don't know. I had this much allocated to this and now it's cost this much, so I'm not doing it.
Do you feel like the sellers think that the market is better than it is and the buyers think it's worse, or is it the opposite?
You know, it's funny you say that. Every buyer I have will send me all the negative statistics. I mean, literally on email. Consumer confidence is this, you know, mortgage rates are
that. So you should be able to get me a great deal.
Exactly. And every seller will say the stock market is up more than ever. You know, it's very funny. Yes.
What about financing? I mean, when you and I spoke last, we talked about the fact that the rich, quite frankly, don't actually need financing. They manage to pay cash. They happen to usually finance about half of it for mm-hmm. whatever reasons. Are you seeing any shifts in cash and carry? Are you seeing any shift in what people want to do as far as financing goes?
People are still looking for financing. They're having as hard a time as last year getting financing. It really hasn't eased up very much. The rates are very low, but it still hasn't eased up in terms of qualifying for the financing. And, you know, people are losing deals to finance at the closing table, which is really a disaster.
Now, this week has brought two pretty big deals. Of mm-hmm. course, we had that landmark property Carlos Slim purchased on 82nd and 5th, one of the last sort of freestanding mansions on 5th Avenue. $44 million, fourth biggest ticket item, I guess, as far as townhouses go. Does that say anything about the market, or is it just an anomaly?
No, I think it does say something. I think it says there is confidence in the market, the high end. Look, someone with all that money doesn't really have to think about it. They want a trophy property. He thinks it's a reasonable price. It's an irreplaceable property, so why not?
And we still heard it needs a little bit of work and a little bit of redecorating.
It needs everything. But you can't replace it, so that makes it
supply
worthwhile.
And demand.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Conan O'Brien's place at the Majestic sold as well.
Exactly, which again was a huge terraced, beautiful apartment that, you know, $25 million is really not a bad price.
Let's talk a little bit about some of the things. 15 CPW, Time Warner Center, The Plaza. These are some of the higher-end properties that have come to market in the past 3 years. Is there any kind of turnover? I mean, a lot of people at Time Warner bought and flipped. Is that possibility gone?
Well, they're still looking to sell apartments. There's actually quite a bit of inventory in Time Warner Center right at this moment. But it's all very high priced, so things aren't moving quickly. The same thing with 15 Central Park West, and probably the same thing with almost any big ticket item. I think the Plaza was the only one of the group that really was in a distressed situation, and everything selling there is selling at what you might think are distressed pricing.
Is there anything that is surprising to you right now, aside from perhaps the lack of depth, that you haven't seen? I mean, you have, you know, more than 20 years experience in this field that you haven't seen before.
Well, you know what I haven't seen before is people not only lacking confidence in the market itself to some degree, but also lacking what are the tax rates going to be? You know, people want all these things answered before they really plunge into a 10-year deal.
So you've never seen people so hesitant about wanting all these nitty-gritty details about maybe factors that are out of their control.
And that's the problem. You know, what's the estate tax going to be? Is a Bush tax cut going to be repealed? You know, they don't know what's happening next year. You know, the governor of Connecticut is trying to take New York buyers. You know, it's all playing out that people are like, wait a minute, what's going on? What am I paying in taxes.
And it's making people hesitate.
Yes, more so than they would otherwise.
That is Realtor to the Stars, Dolly Lynn.